guys, it's 7 p.m. on a Sunday. Who else would it be?
Tune Sick YG with Ain't That Funny from Mad World. Hello everybody, it's been 2 years. Welcome to Radio Redux. For those of you who don't know, Radio Redux was the first Sonic the Hedgehog related podcast that was listed on iTunes. It was the first live streaming broadcast community radio show that was broadcast on Radio Sega and Sega Sonic Radio. And after 200 episodes, I got tired of it, basically. And we left, and there was a big whole thing. And basically what happened was, you know, because it's not like... Like, I'm not busy with other things, like I'm cutting crew. God, the work never stops. Yeah, Casey, who has been an absolute star in helping getting me all this stuff. My God, what happened? It used to be just Sam and it was lovely and stuff. And now we've got 800 programs doing 7 billion things. And yeah, and it wasn't for Casey. But more importantly, Casey asked. He asked and he convinced me that it might be nice. But yeah, 7 p.m. on a Sunday, what else would there be apart from Radio Redux? You know, the thing that was around for about 8 years. Casey says Sam is rubbish. Well, Sam says KC is rubbish, but then Sam's a bit of a gossiper. You know the score. Anyway, gonna do our usual thing. Yeah, we're not going to go into a conversation about Sam Broadcaster, because that's the past. 200 episodes as well, that was the past. Don't care about that. What's going on with the present? Well, so 2016 happened. What a shower. What an absolute never-ending tidal wave of misery and shite that was. It was a hell of a run, 2016. Hey, you go to a party or something, and there's the guy that won't leave you alone, just outstays his welcome. That's what 2016 is. And remember this when you're discussing, like, New Year's Eve, just like, oh, what terrible year 2016 was and everything. The bastard stayed around for an extra day. It was a leap year. Doesn't know when to actually quit or anything at all. Honestly, I don't know. We've got a competition for you coming up. Yes, you have an opportunity to win a very nice Dreamcast bag, courtesy of Insert Coin. It's got the red swirl, just so you know, in case that's of vital importance to you. Anyway, we're going to have, because Radio Reacts doesn't, I know it's Winterfest, with Radio Sega Winterfest, so naturally we're taking the opportunity to play absolutely no winter-related songs whatsoever. Because Winterfest has been going on for a while now. You know. Oh, whoa, the swirl hate coming from the Discord. God damn. Quick, get your tin hat, everybody. Yeah, so we're going to play no winter-related stuff at all, because if people were going to do that, it's already been done by this point, right? Yeah, just play whatever. So, we're going to do that. We've got the competition. But first of all, we need to do the usual thing. We need to do the usual thing on the Radio Relapse, which is we turn to the IRC and we... Oh, wait, we haven't got the IRC anymore. So we need to turn to the Discord. Instead, Team Blue, Team Orange. Look! It's a freaking bag from Insert Coin. Okay, you want it? You know you do. It's fine, honestly. Put a nice. Oh, everyone starts complaining about recolors of consoles now. All right, so get luck reading the name. Says 20. 20 remembers. Right. Got some water here, this might be required. So we've got Radio Reacts starts at the bottom of the list normally, so we're on the Discord. So we've got Saint Nick, Yakuza fan, Tyrese, keep earning that paycheck, Tyrese. Tyonic, Trigon, True, the Mistress of the Skies! Never Leave, the Nick Flair, the Joiner, / Fusion. There's a new toy line coming out with Joiner, new Fusion line. Very special. Supersonic 11231. Sonic Wind Blue, Sonic Remix, Sony, Silver Sonic, Sean, Shadow Remix, Sean, Sarah Rose 96, S2Ped, Ruby Tabuti, Rob, what the flip is that? Rob, registered trademark, KTA. Because of course, Rick Retrix, hello Retrix, Peter Kickass, in brackets too, Place, Petri, Pastel Plushie 64, Panty Gremlin. Many questions, Panty Gremlin. Ozolito, Opox, Omega Mario, Nova Wolfen, Maya Rones. Music Clues is playing iTunes. I hope I'm there. Mumbo King, Mikhail 24RD, Lewis the Jones, Lime, Lily Lang, Kaduyu, Jinjos, Jace Ghost, Jaten, Adden, Jared, Eilis, Hiroshin, Grey 4, Green Viper, General Offensive, Flare, Habanero, Edabine, Eclipse, Drake, Earmuffs, something that gets cut off, Dave the Lurker, Darkwind, Darkspeed, CN, Red Alert, Chikru 1, Charles Ritz, Clapper Claws, Boggle 07, Barak, Atomic Karopi, Arista AF, Aquadan 88, II 1980, and then you've got the Radio Sega posse of Twinny, TCB, Skyblaze 42, Rexy, Ravzig, I need fruit. He needs a flute as well, apparently, but he also needs fruit. Casey, and somewhere, probably listening, he's there somewhere, we know that he is lurking. Not in the chat, I notice, but he's there. There's probably Einigel Venato. Like a rolling stone. Oh no, we're not forgetting that one. That's tradition, we've got to do that. Mr. Wonderman says, I missed people like you, but I'm still but who is that guy? You're not showing up in the list then, mate. I don't know why. That's all the ones I saw. That's all the ones. There are 69 online. Make of that what you will. Also somewhere, Auto DJ. Whatever happened to Auto DJ? I don't know. It's a Marvel vs. Capcom 3. Because Radio Redux plays whatever.
Radio Redux.
Keep your eye out for Dr. Eggman now.
Do you know how hard it was to dig up those ruddy jingles? Anyway, that was the Chase Jail Zone for hell yeah, Rough of the Dead Rabbit. And before that was Danger Room from Marvel vs. Capcom 3. That was pretty awesome. Anyway, I'm a bit at a loss of what to talk about Sega-wise, because they've not exactly done a very good job of keeping my interest. But to keep your interest, let's give you the question that you need to answer in order to acquire this very gorgeous Dreamcast bag from Insert Coin, modelled here by somebody you can't see because A, I didn't have the bag with me, and B, this is radio. Which is a slight problem, really, isn't it? Yeah. Anyway, the question is as follows. So, one of the few things I have been paying attention to with Sega is the Sonic Boom cartoon series, which is really good. And I really wish Sega would actually, you know, promote the freaking thing, but that's another discussion altogether. Anyway, so, your question is going to be Sonic Boom related. Stop sighing and stop crying. It's an easy one. It's the easy one. It's the sort of thing you could look up on, say, a online encyclopedia of all things relating to all things. I don't know that because you'd probably have some kind of more appropriate name. Anyway, question is, who is Sticks the Badger's voice actor? I'll repeat that. Who is Sticks the Badger's voice actor? PM me in the Discord with your answer and I will be picking somebody from random, utterly random, at the end of the show. And they will walk away once the postman has delivered it with that particular piece of accessory. Yes. So, what I'd like to know. So, hello, Discord. This is new. So hello to everybody who's in there. Some familiar faces. They got the most, everyone's complaining about the swirl still. Stop complaining about the swirl! Will we have a queue and talk about how Sega sucks? I'd talk about how Sega sucks, but, you know, they do such a good job of showing it. You know, it's like, well, we could talk about all the fantastic games that have been released this year. Like, and there was, not forgetting the thing, you know, What's It? Yeah. That did wonders. Did everything. Anyway. Oh God, look at all the the small pictures suddenly appear on the left-hand side of my screen. Who should we send the answer to? You should send you the answer to Kevin LMC. That's what you should do. We don't use the AUK name anymore. It kind of, yeah, it's again, it's in the past. We don't talk about it anymore. So yes, I could. Stop going on about the swirl. Oh my God. Really? Oh God. Make the red swirl great again. So much to do, so little time. Let's have some more music, why not? For that. Well, look, is there going to be a Q&A AUK? Well, you can ask me questions. Yeah, you can ask me questions. It's perfectly fine. Just say hello in general and ask me questions about X, Y, and Z. Or, you know, other letters of the alphabet. I'm well versed in my 30 plus years of alphabetizing. Okay. So, we're going to have some. I can feel a poll coming along on the Radio Sega Twitter as to what as to what swirl was the best swirl.
Show me something Dreamcast-y then. Okay, let's see if we can find something Dreamcast related.
2000 Dreamcast SGG Bluff Alignment Afterburner. Would you like some Afterburner? I think he would like some Afterburner. Let's do that. We're going to have some Afterburner. And then afterwards, I'll ask some of your questions. That's perfectly fine. Who are you? No one of consequence. I used to be somebody and they deleted it all. So it's kind of, you know... one of those things. Oh, God. I think Discord would like to... as all the entries just go off the bottom of the screen now. Oh, my goodness me. Right. Afterburner, don't you mean Outrun? I was going to Outrun now. No, you can't run, no, Afterburner. I'll tell you, how about we have Afterburner and then we have some Outrun? Skyblaze appreciates my Princess Bride reference. I'm glad somebody got that. So, we will have Afterburner and then we will have Outrun. Gee, I wonder what Outrun track I will play. Could be anything. It's a meme. Oh, that's probably why I was expecting some kind of information. You know, memes only go so far, and then it becomes a whole shower of crap that means nothing. But anyway, Afterburner. CB, it is not called Nightbird. Never mind getting the planes and the blimmin' cars mixed up. I was asked a question. Do you mean the English voice actor?
Yes. Yes, the English voice actor.
You can put a sock in it now. It's fine. I forgot how long that goes on for. It appears to be several years. Night flight. Alright. We get the gist. Off you go. See ya. There's... people want... 20 wants a specific street by the track. Just so the old Chun-Li jingle, Radio Mix Chun-Li related jingle can come along. I don't know, perhaps we can do that. I do not have that track though, I am sorry to say. I can maybe play something Street Fighter-y. Let's have a look. Let's have a look what's there. Who knows? Could be anything, really. How would you like the Chun-Li remixed version? The remixed theme? From the Capcom Generations Remix album. Would that be okay? Because we can see about that. That's no worries. Okay, that can go in there. There's a little extra track. Yeah, sure, play it. I love that we're just putting an extra track in for this, just so you can have a jingle. It's it's an interesting one. I can't say in the 200 shows previously we came across that. But you know, as you want. I now have to find that jingle though and import it into this menagerie of programs. That's going to be good. Anyway, so it was suggested, and I actually wasn't. Nostalgia runs deep. Apparently so. So we've only got 22 minutes left. I believe it's the Sega Lounge immediately afterwards for those that are sticking around. Although that quite a few, I've actually been quietly in the background all day, and no one's really noticed. But I know a lot of you have been tuned in for the majority, if not the entirety, of Winterfest, which is very impressive. A very impressive event all round from Radio Sega. As usual, as I've come to expect from Radio Sega down the years, excellently managed behind the scenes. So anyway, everyone's still going on about their favourite swirl, because apparently you judge gamers based on the colour of their swirl. And I think that's a terrible shame, and we shouldn't live in a gaming world with such prejudices. And people, we need to start working together, regardless of the colour of the swirl in our Dreamcast, to actually progress, I think, as... you know, as gamers, as human beings, as humanity itself. You know, it's important. Whether your swirl is blue or red or orange, and fortunately it's red on the bag, so you'll just have to make do with that. But whatever it is, we must stand together, shoulder to shoulder as gamers, hold our Dreamcasts high in the air and go, why is this making this horrendous noise? It's important. Seriously, it won't shut up. Also can't connect to the internet anymore on this. What happened to the service? I don't know. Alright, so it was suggested doing some Q&A UK, which is the sort of the Q&A section, if the name didn't give it away a while back then. But we can't call it Q&A UK anymore. I've lost the puns as I don't use the UK name anymore. Q and K-E-V-I-N. Tony hopes the episode title for this includes the Dreamcast Civil War. No, it's actually 201, the Auld Acquaintance Show. It's currently down as. But who knows, it might turn into the Dreamcast Civil War. I feel like I've inadvertently started something here. Alita makes the good point. Alita makes the good point that, you know, all three colours, the swirl colours, represent Sonic, Tails and Knuckles in their mind. Yes! So, essentially, we are all Sonic heroes. This is what it all turns into. All of us together. You, me, the admins... All the other guys who do the shows, yeah. All of us together. Those on social media, those who like the comics and the games, all of us together, as one, we are Sonic heroes. Doesn't it make you feel somehow disappointed in a way that you didn't feel like you would be about a game? I don't know. Here's a remix.
lovely. So yeah, Chudley's theme remix there. And before that we had Brandon Strader, Will-O-The-Wisp, which somebody correctly identified as actually from an OCR competition they had a while back. So well done, whoever that was. I didn't see it. It did end abruptly. It's because of the way the settings are on Radio DJ, and it's weird. And I would have to go through and like manually edit every single point because there's no way to turn off fades apparently, which is kind of weird. The Sonic Zone Remix Competition, says Rexy. I could have sworn there was somebody called Rexy who did really well in that. Yeah, so, but if you want to know what that was a Will-O-The-Wisp, that was the name of the track, and it was a combination of Planet Wisp and Underground Zone. So, yeah, that went very well. Seriously, if you get the nice one, if you get a chance, try and find that one, because there's loads and loads of tracks, and they're all just mashups, or taking the ideas from two different zones, two different levels from Sonic. It's really, really good. 5 minutes until we need to start picking the winner of this thing. You know, this horrendous symbol of division amongst us all. That is, you know, the thing that we didn't... the thing that we really weren't expecting, I think, today was that a bag would end up destroying the community after all the things that have happened to it. I did get some questions. Hang on a minute. Let's see with some Q and blah, 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 blah. TCB says, what Sega games are you looking forward to next year? Are they making any? Honestly, I don't know. Sega had... like I say, I've not done a fantastic job of making me excited for stuff. Obviously, Sonic Mania's on the horizon. I have had an opportunity to play that. It's good. It's good. I mean, I'm not, you know, screaming at the calendar for it to move so I can get my hands on it, though. But I mean, it's really nice, and it's, you know, a direction that somebody probably said that they might have considered going in, you know, many years back. Somebody, goodness knows who. It didn't happen when I gave away the orange swell bag on my show, says Skyblaze 42. Well, I don't know what to say about that. You know, it clearly... clearly it's at this time of night when all the people who are blinded by the colour of a swirl come out. I don't know what to say to you, Skyblaze. Could be anything, really. I got people into a mass hysteria. Yes, dogs and cats were living together. It was all horrendous. Was there any other questions that we had? Do you think the Archie comics will one day work with Sega to produce a game based on the Archie storyline of Sonic the Hedgehog? No, absolutely not. Sonic Team is each their individual universes. The Sonic Team universe, or like a Prime universe, or whatever you want to call it, is one thing, and the Archie universe is another. And I mean, how many times has it been rebooted? It's like 500 or something in the last, you know, 24 months or something. It seems that way anyway. It's not going to happen. I mean, if you did that, then you'd end up with losing a lot of the characters that make the Archie universe what make the Archie universe. Because you're not going to have a Sally over in the main games. I'm sorry. I know there was the cameo, and that was kind of like an official thing. But you know, yes, you could get Archie to do it, but at the cost of everything that makes Archie Archie, and you wouldn't want that. And you know, none of us would really. Any other questions? Any other questions? Someone mentioned Sonic Chronicles. How dare you? War of the Swells. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, the Sonic Mania and Sonic Project 2017. I'm slightly worried that they're destroying Rooftop Run in that opening trailer. Does anybody not spot that? They're kind of dismantling Rooftop Run. So there's lots of people dying in that trailer. But then again, Sega and Sonic is all about death. I mean, for goodness sake, you see Maria get shot. Sonic Team had no problem in showing you the murder of a small child, so it's not like it's anything that's going on. So I'm looking forward to that. No. What's next for Sonic Last Minute Continue in 2017? Millions of videos. Millions of videos I have no time to do. The big things I'm cutting through at the moment, which is the expanded version of the Sonic Boom commentaries that we did for the first season of that, which is now over on the YouTube channel. And we've got the first couple of episodes up of that, which is me, Double Cross, and Donnie. When is Uncutting Crew coming back? We put up an episode like yesterday, Green Viper. We put up an episode like yesterday. You know, it's... But episode yesterday, 3 and 4 are already done. And 3 and 4 are already done with the exception of the pre and post, which I'm literally recording straight after this. Okay, I am literally doing that. It was a stupid YouTube subbox. Yeah, go on there. There's like, yeah, episode 1, episode 2, it's all there. So go. Any more? Other than that, I'm just editing other people's videos. We've got like so many Let's Plays, I do not know what to do with them. But they've got some plans for Let's Plays next year. Hopefully that's going to be really cool. And hopefully a new computer with other things. That's going to be great. I think Sonic and Co. will be back on track like they were before they went downward? It depends. In the minds of the press, never, because they get far too much press from saying, and they wouldn't know what to do. If Sonic was back on track, the actual press would not know what to do, because they rely entirely on saying on the first 3 paragraphs being of any Sonic related article they do being about how Sonic's not as good as it used to be, and then blah 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 blah, Sonic 06, blah 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 blah, Sonic Boom! Blah, 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 blah. This was not as good. That's basically the entirety of everything. What less known Sega IP should be brought back, do you think? Knight, Skies of Arcadia, etc. I hear there's a really good game called Phantasy Star Online 2, which I'm certain that people promised. But... certain people promise, and I'm, you know, because I'm not been keeping things on the ball, I'm positive that there was some sort of promise or vow or inclination that was going to be localized, and I haven't been keeping track, so I'm assuming it was localized, and everything is perfectly fine. So yeah, people getting on about me about the time. I will now. For the benefit of those who have entered. Most people seem to have got the answer right. In fact, everyone's got the answer right. Well, that makes things a lot easier. I'm pleased to say. Okay. We're now going to pop this at random. Okay. And I need to actually do the randomizer wrong. And... Eclipse! Eclipse, a winner is you! So, I need you to message me, and then I'll message, and then I will message KC, who I assume is the person that needs to get everything. So, yes, congratulations to Eclipse. Eclipse is a winner. You are our winner this week. And you win a symbol of much division and anxiety. Congratulations. But especially thank you to Insert Coin. Check them out. And especially if you've got the gaming fan coming up with Christmas on the way. I have got barely any time left at all. Oh my goodness. Anyway, I've got just about enough time. We're not even going to have enough of a thing for a song for going out or anything like that, because I do want to be on time for the guys. A winner as you did not win. No, I'm sorry to say that. But it's been really nice to come back as a little one-off. I see so many familiar faces and people infused about seeing... hearing Radio Riaz again. It was nice anyway. I did forget there was somebody called the winner was you. Curse you and all your creative names. Anyway, for I assume the last time, like I say, go over on the YouTube and LMC YouTube and subscribe, because we've got lots going on. But for the last time, thank you very much for tuning in, and I will see you along down the line. Bye, everybody. Bye-bye.